You get the Georgians who've been making wine for, you know, thousands of years, and they're coming in here, which is a highly high-tech environment. How do you address that sort of dichotomy?
Well, to answer it the way they probably would, it's different. What the biggest problem is they don't have anything like this, because they don't have any instructional centers. So this is a school. For them, wine is made in traditional style. I mean, of course, there are wines that are made in modern style like we make them here, but their wines are different. And it's not to say that all wines have to be made as wines are made all over the world. That's why Georgian wines are very interesting, because they're made in a completely different style of winemaking. And if you ferment in a clay pot, the wines obviously are going to be completely different. But the biggest problem is, why should they stop? It's also a point of difference. And today, in the marketplace, that point of difference is very important.
In what way? Like, what do you mean?
Well, what happens if you have a wine that's the same named grape variety grown in 100 different countries? Do you want it to taste like the 99 other wines grown in different countries? Or do you want it to be slightly different? They have a whole patrimony of grape varieties, and more than 350, things that we have never heard of in the West. Georgia is the birthplace of wine. So obviously, when they're going to take a look at their grape varieties, they're looking at grape varieties that they want to protect because they're theirs. We don't have any grape varieties in California. They're all imported. But we like to say, well, we have Zinfandel, so we try and protect Zinfandel. But it's not indigenous to California. They have grape varieties which are indigenous to their part of the world and only there. That's very important.
Does all this
technology make for better wine? Technology doesn't necessarily make for better wine. Technology makes for sounder wine, wines that you can control. Technology has never made better wine. You can make very, very fine wine using very rudimentary technology. It's still technology, and the idea of fermenting something in a clean container is in fact technology. But here you have the possibility of controlling fermentations that you want to work on specifically to see if that product can be made in a much larger quantity. Why would you start making something, and these containers are 200 liters. Why would you make 1,000 liters of something when you wanted to see whether this system of fermentation could in fact produce a better wine or not?
Right, from you personally, when you walk into a room that has a big computer with graphs on it that's making wine, what is your personal gut feeling when you see something like that?
Now it's sort of perfectly new. It's modern. When I first saw it, well, where's the human element? Where is the art? Because winemaking is not art, in spite of the fact that people say, well, it's an art. Winemaking is a craft, raised the level of art. It's very different. And all this does is allow us to sort of paint a prettier picture. Maybe not necessarily a better picture, but a prettier one.